A recent study conducted shows that about 75% of microwave cable assemblies fail frequently. Damage during installation is one of the lead causes of failure.
Customers have come accustomed to dealing with the fact that a large percentage of the cables that they'll install, they'll immediately have to pull out from the airframe and install new again. To address this issue and to help us establish fitness for use with our own products, we've developed the GORE installed insertion loss tester.
There are six features on the simulator, which is trying to replicate what a cable might see being pulled through an airframe. So I'm going to start it right through here, which is a typical conduit here in position one. And this is to replicate your standard conduit going through an airframe. Now I come back around through station number two, which is another conduit. Now at this point, we're pulling and you'll see that you're getting a minimum bend radius. We'll go ahead and pull the cable straight down to station three, which is a mandrel or pulley. And from there, we go into station four, which is just a hole with an offset edge. So as we pull the cable through, you'll see that this thing hits right on the edge, which is very detrimental to the cable. So once we pull it through here, back up another pulley for another minimum bend radius replication. And then once we get it up through there, we'll go over the last pulley for another minimum bend radius simulation back under here where I can go ahead and pull that through. Pull this just to the end and just leave ourselves enough room to go ahead and test it on the analyzer.
We're gonna connect this end up to our VNA here. We'll focus on insertion loss and VSWR. And compare our data from the data we took before or out of the box to the data we now have after being routed through the simulator. As you can tell in insertion loss, as you get higher in frequencies, there's a lot of instability at these higher frequencies. And if you were to go relate that to those same frequencies on your VSWR curve, you would see large spikes. These spikes are discontinuities in the cable impedance, which were caused by damage that the cable incurred as it was routed through these various stress points in the installation simulator.
And what we anticipate is seeing somewhere between 20 and 40 pounds of torque as you're pulling these things through, or torsional pull.
Hook it up to our VNA. That smooth attenuation curve, that insertion loss curve, is still very well controlled. It's changed slightly, but in a controlled manner, and our VSWR is still very good looking, meaning that we don't have any drastic changes in impedance down the length of our GORE cable assembly.
This is the GORE shake stability test, and it's a great all-around check of a cable's health and fitness. What we're essentially doing is we're subjecting the cable to random shock while connected to a vector network analyzer. Essentially what we're looking for is a change in signal amplitude that's less than 0.01, that's 1/100th of a dB through 18 gigahertz. In the case of this competitive cable, it demonstrated a change of about 0.25 dB, so that's orders of magnitude greater than what we would consider acceptable. In fact, this cable's construction is compromised as a result of going through the installed insertion loss tester. After subjecting the GORE flight cable to the same test, the change in signal amplitude was about 0.01 dB, exactly the value that we're looking for on a cable that's been subjected to the installed insertion loss test. This means this cable would essentially be a fit and forget in an airframe. It would be stable under practically any conditions, vibration, temperature change, gunfire. In other words, this cable is fit for use.
So we've basically demonstrated your typical routing of a cable into an airframe. And once it's in that installed position, we've demonstrated that it'll perform with very little degradation from the time it was brand new out of the box. So in essence, you fit it and you forget it.
We intend it to be installed once, left there in the plane, and to operate over the lifetime of the aircraft.
So the installed insertion loss tester was developed so that we could actually engineer our product to meet and exceed our customers' fitness for use requirements. In the end, the installed insertion loss tester has allowed us to have a product that will minimize replacements, maximize performance, and be a fit and forget solution.